हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम। गुड
मॉर्निंग मैम। गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
मॉर्निंग मैम। गुड मॉर्निंग। ओनली 73 हेड कम। इट्स ऑलरेडी 9:05 बट ओनली 74 75। Either for offline classes or for online classes, your class is always late. No? So hope you are all writing your assignment. Are you getting the topics while searching? Only 3 topics we have given in the assignment. Are you people getting the topics or not while searching? I am asking you people itself whether you are getting the topics while searching or not.
Yes, I am getting topics.
Okay, how many of you have submitted? Raise your hand. How many of you have submitted the assignment till now? 17 submitted. Number 17. Nobody has submitted instead of 17.
Today we will submit, ma'am.
57, huh?
Today, by today evening, ma'am.
Okay. Number 90. Are you hearing now? Gautami, do you hear me now? Gautami, is my voice clear now? Okay, we'll move to the session. So already time is running, but no participants are there. Still 10 members, and about 10 members has to come. Right.
Ma'am.
Sir.
Gautami ki voice clear ledan cheptunnani.
Sir, adhe adugutunnanu sir, nenu kuda.
Ma'am.
అది తనకు వినిపించట్లేదు అనుకుంటా, మిగతా వాళ్ళందరికి ఆడియో ఉంది, తనదే ప్రాబ్లం ఏమో మరి.
అదే మేడం, అక్కడే ప్రాబ్లం, మనదేం కాదండి.
అదే సార్. అవును సార్.
ప్రొసీడ్ మేడం.
ఓకే సార్. We are discussing about the architectural layers of mobile computing. We discussed about the applications also, right? In the yesterday class, we discussed about the novel applications. So there are different variants of the applications of a mobile computing environment or mobile computing devices. So those include the smartphones, enterprise solutions, supply chain management, mobile commerce, e-books, music, video, and everything, whatever not. everything is being done by the mobile computing environment. So we discussed in deep about the smartphones and the speaker phones, how they have been varied in their corresponding features in mobile computing environment itself. That is mobile computing components itself. And enterprise solutions have been using this mobile computing devices for different features like storage management of their data, securing their information, revising the information of their market, and distribution of the information among their co-businessmen and the corresponding customers and whatever it is. And we are all about, and we are all aware about our music world or video world and the book world, how you are being getting the entertainment, how you are being getting the education through this particular mobile computing devices itself. Whether it is maybe through the desktops, whether it may be through the laptops or any corresponding iPods, iPads, tablets, whatnot, whether they may be the wired devices or the wireless devices, if they are the mobile computing capable devices, then they are going to have this particular entertainment world and also the educational world. And we are also performing our e-commerce through the mobile itself without using the desktop or without using any specific fixed devices. We are computing our the payment issues and the payment transactions, and also we are performing the e-commerce transactions using the mobile itself, where we are been calling as the mobile check and the mobile commerce, right? And the business organizations and the business people are using a specific software for their management of their business and the business solutions using the supply chain management softwares. Most of the leading companies and most of the IT leading companies are providing this sort of supply chain management softwares for maintaining different organizations of their producer consumer problems using this supply chain management softwares, right? And coming to the computing architecture, what are the different stages and different layers are existing for a mobile computing architecture? What it has been consisting mainly, the requirements of the mobile computing architecture for retaining in the mobile computing environment to perform its activities, to do all the execute all the applications in the real time, it do require the programming languages, functionalities, the specific functionalities of the operating system and the functionalities of the middleware for the mobile systems. So what are these different programming languages and the functions of the operating system and the middleware will do for us for retaining or executing in the mobile computing environment? Any mobile computing device has to be get programmed for performing its applications. So mostly prominently the Java language will be used for executing or programming the mobile computing device. And JTME and JavaCard will be used for mainly for the applications to program. Whereas J2EE will be used for the enterprise or the server side applications or the server side services. And .NET and Python 2.7 are being nowadays are going to be used for programming this particular mobile computing device. So coming to the functionalities of the operating system, already we know about it is a interface between the hardware and the software and the user and the software and whatever it is. And now the mobile application has to run. It is going to be enabling the user to run any application on the front side or the screen side of the mobile computing device, irrespective of the hardware specification underlying. Whatever the mobile computing device it is, whether it is a tablet or the corresponding iPad or iPod or a laptop or whatever it is a mobile computing device. Whatever the hardware it has been underlying in it, it is going to be running the different functionalities of the operating system. It is going to be running the applications on the front end irrespective of the hardware at the back side. And it is going to be scheduling multiple tasks at a time. It is going to managing the memory for you. It is going to be managing the different tasks for you. It is going to be interfacing different communication world, which has been connected with, that is the mobile computing device, may be connected with many number of communication devices parallelly. So all those interfaces will be maintained by the operating system. It is going to be configuring the different types of libraries that are being engaging with different APIs or GUIs of the corresponding interfaces, and it is also handling the middleware that are helping the mobile computing environment, right? And what is the middleware? The middleware, what it has been helping, how it has been aiding for the mobile computing device? It is nothing but a device which is going to be helping the corresponding mobile computing device in identifying the corresponding communication device that are surrounded by the mobile computing device, and also different databases that are being existing, networks that are being existing around our device. And it is also helpful for us to get compatible with that particular networks, get compatible with that particular communication devices to get connected with. Well, because if you want to get connected with a specific network and if you want to switch from one network to another network and to identify what are all the devices that are present around our device, who doesn't know about the devices that are present around our device in a specific distance, if you have to find out, we are going to scanning. So how that particular scanning will be done, how you are going to get that particular devices list, how you are going to getting connected with that, whether they have been compatible or not compatible, how you are being get intimated, all this intimation, that is whether the device can be connected or device cannot be connected, or devices are available or not, how many number of devices are available, what are those, what are their names, all this can be listed and all this can be identified using the middleware devices. All these are, I mean, this particular middleware related functionalities are also been retained with the operating system itself. It is going to taking care of the corresponding functionalities of the middleware, right? And coming to the architecture, so we are been discussing about the architecture and the requirements. So where these requirements are been working and what are all the different components that are been working with this architectural components, that is, the architectural components are nothing but the functionalities of the operating system, programming languages, and the middleware, what we discussed. So where this particular components are been existing and how they are been working in the working with the internal components of the mobile computing device, whether they may be the software components or maybe the hardware components, all are going to be working with the different architectural components that we've been discussed. See, at the top of this particular mobile computing device, we'll be having the client application. That is, we can see the client application. We are invoking the client application. You are been working with the client application. What this client application internally get connected with in order to execute it for us, I mean, and it's going to be running. While it is running, what it has been connected with? It is going to connected with different GUIs, different phone APIs, and different middleware components, and also the different communication APIs. So what the application has been running by us, and where it is being connected with, whether it is having any interface specifically, and it has been covering the phone API, or it has been completely occupying the application API itself, or how, what sort of communication devices to which you are being connecting with, what are their APIs, and what are all the different middleware that you are going to use to get connected with different communication APIs. The middleware components are useful for us to get connected with the communication APIs, and to get engaged with that particular APIs, GUI API will be useful, and to get contact with the phone, we'll be having the phone API. These are all get connected with our client application with the help of the programming languages that you are being done with. The client application will be running with the program, and all these APIs and all these middleware components, whether they may be the management, network, database components, Bluetooth, communication protocol, email, whatever it is, or an interface or a dialog box or whatever it is that you are seeing on the screen of a client application, all are being run by the programming languages or the programming part or a programming tool that we have used to communicate or used to run our application, right? So all these are been running on the programming components. So once these are all been running, who are been running background at behind these components, even though you are using the program for running this application, we are dividing these applications into different ways, that is GUIs, phone APIs, middleware components, communication APIs, and all these things are there, and client application has been running. All are based on the programming code that has been written by us or written by the mobile computing experts. All this has to be run on the operating system itself with the help of the operating system underlying in the mobile computing device, whether it is a laptop, whether it is a tablet, whether it is an iPod or iPad, whatever it is, there should be an operating system. A client application will be there. It is running with the help of the communication APIs. It is running with the help of the middleware components using the GUI, phone API. All this has to be run. All this has to be executed. All this has to be scheduled with the help of the operating system itself. Without the operating system, no application and no API will be get operated in a sequence, and they will not be get scheduled. So this operating system is being communicating with the underlying hardware. As it is an interface between the software and the hardware, as it is the interface between the user and the system, it has to get communicated with the underlying hardware of the mobile computing device. So what the underlying hardware that is going to be there on the device, Device hardware consisting of a display device, keyboard, RAM, flash devices, embedded processor will be there, a media processor will be there, media communicating components will be there, audio devices will be there, video devices will be there. Different components are being existing. That is, from a mobile computing device, we are able to see the screen, we are able to see the video, and we are able to hear the audio from it, and you are able to see different applications that are being running over, and you are being typing on it, you are getting the storing the different data onto that particular mobile computing device. So for doing this, we do require certain components. All these components will be get contact and interact with the operating system itself. That is, operating system is taking care of client application, it related components, it's related software components, and also where the software components will be get working with the help of the hardware itself. All these software components are going to be getting worked. So this particular hardware components also to be get organized by the operating system itself. So it's been acting as an scratch pad or a basis for both the software and hardware to get coordinate and to get work with. Okay. And once the device is being ready with all these components, its computation has been get worked out, it has been ready to send the data to somewhere, then it has to approach some interface, right? We are being done with our applications in our system, in our mobile computing device. But once if you want to send the data, or if you want to communicate with other person on the other side, from the other computing device or from other mobile computing device, then we have to get out of our device. So from that particular device, from the physical or the hardware device, the signal has to be sent outside. Signal has to be sent outside from the hardware parts itself. So where it has to be sent through, that is to the network first we have to connect with. So that we are being identifying the interfaces, gateways, network interfaces, radio interfaces, whatever it is. That whatever the signal that we want to send to outside, those interfaces has to search for to get connected with the network. So that the hardware is going to be finding out the network, corresponding network interfaces. From that particular network interfaces, it is going to be connecting to the network, right? So from there onwards, we are being getting communicated with the other party or other communicating device or other mobile computing device. So on that particular side itself, the same thing will be happening. It is going to be executing. It has been raising a client application. It has been enabling all the APIs and the middleware and the communication APIs. It has been communicating with the operating system. It has been working along with the hardware and finding out the interfaces. The receiver side, I'm talking about. On the receiver side, mobile computing device itself, the same is going to be happening to get communicate with them, to exchange applications, and all these things are going to be happening, right? Right. Coming to the layers. Layers have been defined according to the OS organization. We've been defined what are all the applications, interfaces, devices, network hardware, all are being different layers of the mobile computing device. And coming to the protocols, we listed about all these set of protocols which have been working with the mobile computing device depending upon the version of the device. We're having the GSM protocols, we're having the CDMA protocols, we're having the WPAN protocols, wireless LAN protocols, wireless application protocols are there, Bluetooth, IRDA, ZigBee, all these are the different set of protocols which are used in the mobile computing environment. We'll discuss in detail about what are all these protocols, why, where and when they will be used, what are all their versions, what are all their specialties, we'll see while discussing about the protocols. Only this is a list of the protocols which are used in the architecture, right? Coming to the layers, already you know about the OSI layers used in the networks for transferring your data or connecting to the network or communicating among the different networks, right? And coming to this layers, especially a specific layers which will be used for mobile computing environment are the three layers, that is the physical, data link, and transport layers. Physical is being useful for sending and receiving the signals. Mostly TDMA and CDMA coding procedures will be used at the physical layer in the mobile computing environment. And coming to the data link, it will be used for communicating the data and getting connected with the networks. So that multiplexing, that is getting connected with multiple connections and multiple communicating devices, the data link layer will be useful for us. And wireless transport layer security, while transmitting the data, how the data will be get secured, how the security mechanisms will be implemented, end-to-end encryption will be our end-to-end connectivity, end-to-end transferring of the data will be performed by the wireless transport layer security. And coming to the transaction protocol, how that particular data will be get conveyed, what are all the different protocols and the rules will be followed while conveying your data through this particular three layers, either at the physical level, either at the data level or at the transport level, how the communication will be get carried or conveyed while using the wireless transition protocols, wireless application environment, wireless transaction protocols, all are going to be aiding with these three layers to transmit the data from one communicating point to the other communicating point, either in one-to-way communication, one-to-many communication, or many-to-many communication paths. And coming to the limitations of mobile computing, we have been discussing every time the advantages of the mobile computing devices. What could be the limitations? What could be the disadvantages of a mobile computing environment and mobile computing a device? So what may be the disadvantages, whatever may be the advancements come in the mobile computing technology, what may be the advantages, what may be the advancements come in the mobile computing technology, there are some disadvantages still retained with that particular mobile computing environment. The first and the foremost constraint, that is the resource constraint, which is the main resource constraint, is the battery. Already you know about that. Whether it may be an iPod or an iPad or a laptop or a mobile or whatever it is going to be deficient with the battery. That is, continuously and for a long interval of time, we won't be able to get the power source with the use of the battery. With the use of the battery, we won't be getting survived for long time interval. That is a resource constraint. That is the main constraint and the main disadvantage of the mobile computing environment. And next one is interference. As our mobile computing device or the mobile computing environment is going to use the radio transmission of the signals, most of the mobile computing devices, mobile computing transmissions will be radio transmission. Most of the radio transmission will be getting the interference, as it is not going to have any shielding and guidance as in the transmission media. That is, it will not be through the guided transmission media, it will be unguided transmission media, unguided transmission of the radio signals. There will be much of the interference. There may be chance of disturbance of the signals. Okay, interference is nothing but getting interrupted by the external sources with this particular radio transmission of the signals. So whenever there will be a interference from the external sources, obviously we will be having the loss of rate of transmission rate, and you are also getting the loss of data also. Transmission rate is also been decreased, and obviously delays will be there because of the reduction of the transmission rate, and also you are getting the loss of data because of this interference. And at the same time, bandwidth. Even though the transmission rates are, even though the corresponding advancements are there, are been increasing in the corresponding mobile computing environment. That is, as we are going to increasing the speed, when compared to the physical or the end-to-end transmission using the hardware transmission and the desktop transmissions, these wireless transmissions are always deficit in their transmission rates. That is, the bandwidth rates are being very lesser when compared to the communication or the direct contact, I mean intact point-to-point communication transmissions. When compared to the point-to-point communication transmissions, this particular wireless transmissions are always deficit in their bandwidth rates. When compared to them, they are all having very lesser while transmitting. Even though they are being fixed for very higher transmissions, while transmitting they will be losing their bandwidth rates. Okay, so first one is the resource constraints. That is nothing but the mainly the battery. Second one is the interference, that is the disturbances that are being caused by the external resources while transmitting in the air. And next one is bandwidth, that is reducing the transmitting rates. Next one is dynamic changes in communication environment. That is, we all know that the particular mobile signals or the mobile communicating signals or the radio signals are transferring to various media and various heights and various geographical resources or the areas. It is going to be covering the different areas, very higher areas, higher altitude areas, and the lower altitude areas. And it is going to be covering various different material like lakes, mountains, forests, buildings. There is nothing but reinforced concrete buildings. So all these surfaces are going to be get covered by this particular radio signals or the mobile computing signals. So while transmitting through all these particular different environments, that is through the lake or through the mountain or through the crops or through the forest or through the buildings or through the people, okay, and lying over different altitudes, but that is dynamically changing over different communication environments, not through a single or a constant communication path will not be there, or the communication media will not be there. Depending upon the direction of the destination, the communication signal will be changing its path. According to the particular path, it is moving through different areas, it is moving through different paths and objects. So in that way, it is going to be taking different delays, and it may be losing connections, it may be losing the data rates, it may be losing the transmission rates, it may be losing the data also, okay? Next one is network issues. Because of the larger distance coverage and because of the different altitude areas it is going to be covering, there may be chance of connecting and disconnecting with the networks. That is, larger areas and larger altitudes and the lower altitudes may not be getting the network transmission at higher rates at all the times. There may be chance of network connectivity, network disconnectivity, and the network stability will not be there, connection stability will not be there. That is another disadvantage. And next one is interoperability issues. This will be common for every working environment, but maybe the network connected or network not connected, disconnected. Every connecting issues and every communication devices will have this interoperability issues, like getting power off, getting tear off, everything because of the components, because of the software problems. Everything will be there because of the interoperability issues. So that what are all the limitations we are having in the mobile computing? Resource constraints will be there. Interference will be there, bandwidth issues will be there, dynamic changes in the environment will lead to the reduction in the transmission rates, network issues will be there at the higher altitudes and the lower altitudes and the remote areas, everything will be there, and interoperability issues will be there for the corresponding software and hardware related problems, right? These are all the limitations. And finally, the security constraints. The security constraints will be ultimately prone to different eavesdropping. That is, not only the portable devices are being stolen, radio interfaces are also going to be prone to the eavesdropping. They have been tapping, and they have been tapping the information from the wireless signals also. So that every wireless devices which are being communicated should be provided with the end-to-end authentication and also end-to-end encryption and security mechanisms has to be offered. Until and unless we are being posed with the security constraints, we couldn't able to hold our secure our data in the wireless communication also, right? There will be eavesdropping even in the radio interfaces. So that security constraints are also one of the problem in the mobile computing environment. And we'll see a simple reference model where we could see different communication devices that are being communicated through the network, through the phone network, having different communication layers or communication levels. See here, a tab is there where they have been communicating using some stylus, and this particular tab is going to be communicating itself with this particular layers, that is this particular five layers. Okay, these five layers are going to be communicated with that particular tab. And here, a particular radio device or radio operating or a server side, the server is going to be operating again with the five layers. And this particular tab is going to be communicating with the network using the radio interface. This particular tab is going to be communicating with its five layers with the network using the radio interface. This is the wireless communication, right? And this particular network base station is going to be working with both the network layers, data link layers, and the physical layers. Okay, and now the corresponding device, which is going to be a server device or a particular end device or the destination device, which is going to be communicating with the network, intact with the network, using the connectivity. For example, say it may be a modem, it may be a router, or any server, whatever it is. That particular server is directly connected with the corresponding network. Okay, this particular that particular server device has been connected with the network device using a medium directly. Here the radio interface is being used by the tab, and whereas the server is being using directly a medium to get connected with. So how they are being communicating? Only the network is being required in the network and data link and physical layer, whereas the corresponding tab or a tablet or iPod or iPad or whatever it is, and the corresponding the mobile device or the server side or the destination device or any particular modem or a router, which is going to be operating with again five layers, it is going to be connected with the medium. So what these layers and what these communication devices which are being helpful for us for communication, and this is the antenna which is going to be connecting to your wireless device, right? So through wireless device you are been sending the signals to the antenna. Antenna has been receiving through that particular network operating device, and from the network operating device the signal will be transformed to our destination device, and all these devices are going to be get communicated with the help of these five layers which are been communicating the signals through the network. We will see with this particular reference model, that is with a wireless device we are communicating with a wired device with the help of the network. With a wireless device, we are communicating with a wired device with the help of a corresponding communication network. So we'll see what happens with that each and every devices. So here, these two systems, that is the tab and the corresponding destination device, whether it may be a server or maybe any other device, these systems are called as end systems. These systems are called as end systems. And the medium that you are going to use here and the corresponding devices through which you are being communicating are called as intermediate devices, are called as intermediate devices. And there will be middleware devices. Already we discussed about devices which are been helping us the communicating parts to find out the surrounding hardware devices and surrounding communicating devices and surrounding networks. So what about the middleware systems? Intermediate systems are there, end systems are there, and communicating terminals or the network systems are there. Here, three category of the devices, how these are communicating and how these are communicating with the corresponding layers, we will see here. See, what are these? A simplified reference model may be consisting of one category called as end systems. One category called as end systems may be consisting of a PDS and a computer or whatever it is. They are going to be needing a full stack of all the layers, full stack of all the layers, that is application layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and the physical layer. So these systems, these end systems which are being communicating on the other side of the communication network, do require that total full protocol stack of the layers. Okay, they are being communicating with the lower layers. It's application on the end side communicating with the other using the lower layer services, not the upper layer services. Even though the end systems are being consisting of the full protocol stack of all the layers, they are communicating with the other devices using the network, only the lower layer services, right? And coming to the intermediate system, that is the networking systems, they do not require all the layers, they just require the three layers as shown in the figure, that is the network, physical, and the data link layers. Only the three layers are being required by the intermediate systems like the networking units. Right. Coming to the layers. So what are all the layers that we are have and what they are fetching for us and what they are aiding for us in communicating? Right. Coming to the physical layer, this is the lowest layer or lowest part of the communication device, and which has been responsible for converting our stream of data to be transmitted as a form of a signal. So stream of bits into the signals and signals into the bits in the vice versa fashion. Okay, already you know about this, how the physical layer is being helpful for us, what the physical layer is doing. It is being helpful for us in communicating our signals into the form of the bits and converting again bits into the signals while transmitting over the air or the medium. And most responsibilities, the responsibility of the physical layer in terms of the communication is, it is going to be helpful in selection of the frequencies and generation of the carrier frequency and signal detection, modulation of the data into a carrier frequency and encryption. Already we have seen that what is the carrier signal, what is the modulation, and how the encryption will be done. Already we know about how the encryption procedures, right? So that what is the frequency of the signal to be chosen, how it is to be generate a carrier frequency signal according to the signal that is being generated internally, and how the signal has to be detected that is being received from other communication device, how the carrier signal has to be get modulated to the corresponding chosen parameter, that is whether it is to be amplitude modulated, frequency modulated, or the phase modulated, and finally how the signal has to be get encrypted while it is leaving the device into the medium. So that all these functionalities has to be performed by the physical layer instead of converting the signal to the bit and bit to the signal. Okay, stream of bits into the signal bit, signal stream, and signal stream into the bit streams. Instead of that particular functionality, it also has to identify that what is the frequency of the signal, what is the carrier frequency, how it is to be chosen, how it is to be modulated, how the signal has to be get encrypted before it is leaving the device. All these responsibilities has to be taken care by the physical layer. And coming to the data link layer, this data link layer is mainly responsible for accessing the medium, how the data has to be sent over the medium, whether it is receiving the data from the medium or sending the data to the medium, what are all the different data streams it has been receiving, how many number of channels from which it is going to accessing the data, and all those things, whether it is getting the erroneous data, whether the data is being synchronized according to the time, whether it is being transmitting in the synchronous transmission or the asynchronous transmission, whether we are having the point-to-point communication among the different communicating devices, all these things will be taken care by the data link layer. It is going to be taking access of medium, multiplexing of different data streams, if multiple data streams are being sending over or receiving, and correction of the transmission errors, if any received or been sending, and synchronizing according to the time interval and according to the time slots, we are encrypting and decrypting the data or not, or you are accessing the data bits or not. So that it is being responsible for reliable point-to-point communication between the two communicating parties and two multiple communicating points or whatever it is, and different servers and the senders and the receivers. That is the part of the data link layer. And coming to the network layer, already you know about that, how it has been useful for us. It is going to be routing the different communication points, how the packet and how the data is to be routed from the sender to the receiver while establishing the connection between the two parties, while establishing the connection between the two parties. So that the important functionalities of a network layer could be the addressing, routing, device location, and handover between the different networks. That is how the addressing, that is other party address, has to be find out, how that particular address has to be get routed with, how the device location has to be identified to send the data over or to get the data from. Okay, the two parties has to be identified with all these things. That is, the sender has to identify the router and route, receiver, and receiver has to identify the sender, and they has to identify their each location. And they has to identify, and they has to taken care of. That is, the network layer has to taken care of. They has to taken care of not only the address, routing, device location, they also has to taken care of handover between the different networks. Handover is nothing but how you are going to handing over. That is, from hand to the hand, we are handing over an object to some other hands. We are handing over an object to some other hands. What you are been handing over? Here you are handing over the signals from one network to the another network. That is, we are been, that is, as a sender, we are been working with some signals network or one network signal. And our party, receiving party, will be working with some other network. Both are of different. So their antennas will be different, their receivers will be different, the transmitters will be different. We are being connecting to our own network antenna. While you are sending the signal, we are being connecting to our own network antenna. So from that particular antenna, it is been transmitting the signal to the air. So once the signal has been sent to the air, the signal is been searching for corresponding destination address and destination antenna first. So once the corresponding antenna has been identified, for example, myself has been sending the signal through the Airtel mobile or Airtel signal, Airtel network signal. I am sending the signal to the Airtel network antenna, and the Airtel network antenna is sending the signal into the air with itself. So once it is being sent over air, it will be neutral. The signal will be neutral. So it is been identifying the receiver's signal antenna, receiver's signal antenna, so that the receiver may be of an idea customer, an idea communicating point, or maybe a particular Vodafone, whatever it is, or maybe a Reliance, or maybe a Jio. So that particular antenna has to be searched by the signal in the air, so that whatever the signal that have been sent myself from the ITEL antenna, which has been traveling in the air, has to received by the corresponding network antenna. So that once the network antenna has been received, the action or the performance of the signal sent by my ITEL antenna, which has been received by the corresponding Idea antenna or the Reliance or the Jio antenna, receiving by it, once it has been received by it, the handing over of the signal from the ITEL antenna to the Idea antenna or ITEL network to the Idea network is called as handing over. The signal from the one network to the another network will be conveyed and it will be relayed, is called as the handover between different networks. If it is of the same network, it will not be called as handover. But if it is of different networks, they are being communicating over, the signal will be handing over from one network to the another network. That is about the network layer functionality, right? Next one is transport layer. Already we know about just transmitting the data. Once the network establishes a connection, network establishes a connection between the two parties, establishing a connection between this particular two points, that layer is going to be transmitting the data from end to the end connection. Networks are being get connected. An end-to-end connection would be get established with the transport layer, and the transmitting of the data will be done in a smooth way. Right? And coming to the application layer, already you know about this particular application layer, which is situated at the top of our protocol stack and the layer stack. And it is the one which is responsible for running our application, sending the signal outside of the device and receiving the signal from the outside of the device. So whenever you have to receive the signal, this application layer has to receive the signal from the other device. And whenever you have to send the signal from that particular application itself, this application layer is going to be working on. So that the functionalities of the application layer could be, service location has to be identified, supporting the multimedia content, adapting the application that can handle the larger variations in transmission, wireless accessing to the World Wide Web, that is accessing the internet, accessing the portable devices, identifying the service areas, identifying the multimedia content that has been received over different signals. That is nothing but whatever the signal that has been received from the other networks or the other communicating points, all are to be handled. That is, after the physical layer work data or the sending signal from the physical layer, reaching the data link layer, reaching the transport layer, reaching the application layer and whatever it is, what network layer, transport layer, then it is being received by the other party through the application layer. So at that particular point, the fruit of the signal which is being, or the complete form of the signal which is being received at the application part, we are been receiving it and processing it using in our device. And at the same time, from the device itself, we are being sending the signal from the application layer. And the particular other device, communication device, and the receiving device is also receiving the signal from our side through the application layer itself. And it is going to be dumped back through the different layers of processor to the physical layer to use through that particular device. And this sequence of operations already you know about in this computer networks. No need to explain all these things in detail. How these particular layers have been working in upward fashion and downward fashion according to the data received, according to the data sent over the network, right? This is about the reference model and different application, different layers that are being involved in communicating the data and conveying to the networks and connecting to the networks, establishing the communication connections between the different communicating points. So basically, whatever may be the seven layers existing on the end systems of the communication points, the corresponding network devices only using the three layers, that is the physical data link and the networks layers, those three layers are sufficient for the services among the mobile computing environment devices or mobile computing devices. Okay, so the end systems are requiring both all the seven layers of the five layers protocol stack, whereas the networking device which is being intermediating between these two end systems include the computer systems, PDAs or the laptops or iPods and whatever it is, they are going to communicating with each other by connecting to the network. The network device only requires three lower layer services, that is nothing but the physical data link and the corresponding network layer. Using the three layers itself, it is going to get communicating the data between those two end systems. Right, we have seen how those three layers are helpful for us identifying the frequency of signals, converting the signals, identifying the networks, handing over the signals over the different networks, establishing the proper connection and conveying the signals, identifying the multimedia content using the application layer and all those things. So this is how a particular mobile computing device using its layers of protocol stack to communicate and to get the signals and to get to work with, and how the different architecture components are being useful for us. Okay, and here our mobile computing fundamentals part has been ended in the second part of our first unit. First part relates with the mobile communication and second part related with the mobile computing and also the GSM. So mobile computing fundamentals are also being ended here. We'll be discussing with the GSM protocol, how the GSM has been aiding us in communicating with all of us and how it is being become popular, what are its characteristics on and all those things we'll be discussing in the next class. Okay, we'll be discussing with the GSM protocols and GSM architecture, its reference models, its protocols, its versions, how it has been waiting, how it became popular in this mobile computing environment, all we can see in the next class. It's already over. Hope all are been completing the assignments. Do complete before the due time. I'm ending the session here. Time is over. Okay.